Welcome to the guide how to make currency. Let's start with general tips. There are lots of ways to earn currency and some of them require specific builds. So if you wish to focus, let's say, on labyrinth farming, you need to pick one of the builds that is good for that type of content. Sometimes, depending on ways you wish to earn your currency, you will need to create more than one character. Second, you will need to use good loot filter. My advice is to use Never Sinks. For leveling, you should use normal or semi-strict version. Few hours before the start of new league, be sure to download new updated version. Third, here are the websites you should use while playing this game. For trading, you can use official Path of Exile website, or you can use website like poe.trade. For the build guides, you can use poebuilds.cc. There you can see most popular builds by forum views and also guides that are recently added. Next excellent website is poe.ninja. There, after you select league, you can find history of item prices and currency exchange rates. Items are divided in categories and for each category you can see which items are most expensive. Also, you can go to builds page and see which are most popular builds for that league. For crafting, I'm using website poedb, and for labyrinth farming, you should check poelab.com. There, beside full labyrinth guide, you can find all kind of other useful guides, so be sure to check this website. Fourth, there are third-party tools that can help you be more efficient with your time, like PoE Trade Macro and Mercury Trade. Finally, you will need to set up your shop. In case you have premium stash tabs, it will be easy and fast. At the start of league, I usually set prices at 1, 3 and 5 chaos and just drop items I wish to sell inside those stashes. And if I notice that items, let's say in stash with 5 chaos are not selling, then I just move them to stash with lower price. In case you don't have premium stash tabs, you can watch video How to Start Trading in Path of Exile, which explain how to use third-party tool acquisition to set up your shop. Link to this video, website and third-party tools you can find in description. Now let's talk about strategies you can use to get currency. At the start of League, best way to make currency is to rush to maps, finish Zana quests for memory fragments so you get all Shaper orbs, and then kill Shaper for Elder Orb. Then you can use Elder Orb on some good map like Underground Sea and start running tier 16 Elder maps. If your character is not able to defeat Shaper, you can pay for boss killing service and defeat Shaper that way. When you run the Elder map, be sure there is influence on it, either Shaper or Elder, so you have chance to get Shaper or Elder base items. Also, to improve your leveling speed, you can watch two videos from Zizaran, Leveling Tips and Full Racing Leveling Guide. In 3.6 expansion, Zana Beyond map is back, will cost 4 chaos, and no longer grant 20 quantity, but Beyond bosses will be able to drop maps. So players who are able to defeat those bosses in heavily modified maps can go for double Beyond map mod. Next question is where to invest currency you make in the early start of the league. If you visit PoE Ninja, you can see that in Betrayal League, some items like Monstrous Treasure Prophecy, Mortar Ignorance Fragment, and Natural Instinct Unique Jewel, and of course Mirror of Kalantra, increased in value over time much more than Exalts, and if those items are not changed for a new expansion, you should invest in those items. Farming low depth delve. In Betrayal League, this was one of the best ways to make currency, especially for solo play. Main point of this strategy is low cost, both in sulfite and currency you need to invest. Because monsters at low depth are under level 70, you can invest more in movement speed and less in damage and defense. To get most profit with this strategy, be sure to sell your fossils and resonators in bulk. Let's say you have 20 metallic fossils for sale. Instead of checking price for one fossil, look for minimum stock of 20 and you can see how price is increased. This works for most items that can be sold in bulk. In Betrayal League, perfect depth for this kind of farming was between 40 and 64. At depth 65, cost in sulfite increased by 50% without almost any rewards increase and was less efficient. Depending on changes for Delve in new expansion, this perfect depth can change. In new 3.6 expansion, sulfite scarabs are 60 to 70% less effective depending on tier, and gathering sulfite will probably take more time. But because this strategy requires low cost in sulfite, I think it will stay as one of the best ways to make currency in new Synthesis League. To see this strategy in detail, you can watch video How to Farm Low Delves for 400 plus chaos per hour. Link will be in description below. Next strategy is Labyrinth Farming. People who love spending time in Labyrinth can make lots of currency from selling helmet enchants and from opening Izaro treasure chests. You can visit PoE Ninja website, pick the league and see which enchants are most expensive. When you get one with high price, you need to visit trading website and compare prices for this enchant depending on what helmet you used. Also, this way you can find what type of helmets combined with enchants are most expensive. Though you can make some currency by farming Merciless, for maximum profit you need to farm Eternal Labyrinth. For this you will need to finish 6 map trials. To get these trials fast, you can open General Chat 820 and join party with people who share those trials. Also, don't be like me and forget to use twice Enchanted Prophecy. While most of the time you will enchant helmets, in case you have some expensive boots for sale, you can enchant those as well, as it may increase the price and chance for selling. One really important change for new 3.6 expansion is that Labyrinth enchants no longer override implicit mod on items. So now you can place these enchants on items like Bone Helmet and 2-ton boots and have both enchant and implicit mod. Also in new Synthesis League, there is a device called Synthesizer that lets you destroy fractured items to create base items with custom implicit mods. These implicit mods are somewhat controllable by careful choice of input items to consume. To make most profit, if you use non-unique helmets for lab enchants, now you will need to combine best implicit mod with best enchants. If you already don't know, fractured items are new type of items that can have up to 3 fixed mods. Beside enchants, by farming Labyrinth, you can make profit by opening Izaro treasure chests. Here is loot you can get from these chests. If you never farmed Labyrinth and wish to try, you can use website like PoE Lab where you can find all information you need for Labyrinth farming, including daily layouts with useful notes, list of recommended builds, basic information and basic guides. Beside Labyrinth information, here you can find other useful guides like leveling and endgame bosses guides. One of the easiest ways to make currency is by leveling gems. You should always use your second weapon set to level up 6 additional gems. My advice is to use 2 one-hand weapons. Your goal is to level up those gems to level 20. At that point you have 4 options. First, you can sell them as uncorrupted level 20. Second, you can risk and use Val Orbs on those gems. Third, you can risk and use special device inside Doriani Institute in Incursion Temple in hope of getting level 21 Val version of your gem. And finally, you can sell to vendor your level 20 gem with one gem cutter prism, and you will get that same gem but level 1 with 20 quality. Now you level up that gem again to level 20 and you will have level 20 gem with 20 quality. Again, you have similar 3 options: sell it as uncorrupted 20 gem, use Val Orb and try to get level 21 gem with 20 quality for higher profit. And third, you can use special device inside Doriani Institute room in Incursion Temple, which will corrupt this gem twice, and try to get level 21 Val version of your gem with 20 quality. If main skill for your build is strength base, you should level up red gems. If it's int base, blue gems, and if your main skill is dex based, you should level up green gems. Though there is one trick that can help you level up off color gems. Let's say you play witch and your main skill is int base. and you wish to level up Green Gem like Blade Vortex. You can buy cheap one-hand weapons with plus 50 dexterity, and then use two of those in your second weapon set, which will give you plus 100 dex. Because level 20 Blade Vortex require 150 dexterity, you will need just 55 dex more on your gear or talent tree to be able to level up this gem. In case your dexterity really suck and you have less than 55, you can buy cheap amulet with dex that will solve this problem. And it's time to level up your gem, you just switch to your second weapon set, equip if need that amulet, level up gem, then switch back to your main weapon set and amulet. If you decide to level up gems like Empower or Enlighten, keep in mind that those gems can only reach level 3 through regular experience gain. But required experience to reach that level is considerably greater than experience normal gems need to reach level 20. Also, for these gems, investment is much higher than for normal gems. They are not sold by vendor, you can get them as drop or buy from trade. Then you need to use Gemcutter's Prism to increase their quality to 20, and also you will need to invest in one-head weapons with mod that increase quality of socketed gems. In Betrayal League, to speed up process of leveling gems, players place Tora inside the research safe house. If she was rank 3, her crafting bench would increase experience of gem for 200 million, and if used on Empower with 20 quality, increase was 400 million experience. I'm guessing this reward will be nerfed in 3.6 expansion. To find out which gems to level up based on their price at level 20 or 21, you should use poe.ninja website. There, choose league in which you play, click on skill gems, then choose level and quality and see what gems are most expensive. Another easy way to make some currency, though usually less efficient, is by using vendor recipes. To see full list of vendor recipes, you can visit Path of Exile wiki website. Here are some of most important. For any 6 socket item, you will get 7 jeweler orbs, and for 6 link, you will get 1 divine orb. Next time, when you try to sell your corrupted 6 link and wonder why so many people want to buy it, you will know that you choose price that is much less than 1 divine orb. Next recipe many players call Beginner's Trap. It is chaos recipe for which you need to vendor full set of rare items, minimum level 60 up to level 74 to receive 1 chaos orb. If all items are unidentified, you will receive 2 chaos. If items are level 75 or higher, you will get regal orb instead of chaos. Here is how and when I use this recipe. While leveling my first character, as soon as I reach level 60 zone, I start doing chaos recipe by vendoring a rare set of unidentified items to receive 2 chaos for each set. I use these chaos orbs to buy crafting bases like elder belts and elder rings, and I also buy currency I need for crafting like alteration and regal orbs. Investing this starting currency in crafting and selling items I craft usually brings me high profit. I will tell you more about this in crafting section of this guide. Best time for doing chaos recipe is start of new league when chaos orbs still have high value. Over time, as chaos orbs lose their value, this recipe will be less and less efficient way of making currency. Next important recipe is for unique body armor Loreweave. You need to vendor 60 random unique rings. Let's say minimum price for this armor is 120 chaos. If you manage to buy 60 unique rings at 1 chaos each, you can make 60 chaos profit. Most important mod on this armor is one that increases player maximum resistances, and when you try to sell it, be sure to set price based on this mod. Next important recipe is similar to chaos recipe, but this time you need full set of rare items that are either all shaper or all elder based, for which you will get 2 exalted shards. This time, I don't recommend vendoring unidentified items for double reward, because some shaper or elder based items can be really expensive, especially rings and amulets. Also, some shaper and elder based items that are used as crafting bases are also expensive, you should not use them in this recipe. Easy solution is to store all shaper and elder items you plan to use for recipe in premium stash tabs, set tabs to public, and set price at let's say 5 chaos. If you put there some expensive item, you will receive lots of messages from people wanting to buy it. Now you need to invest some time and find a real price for that item. Next method for making currency is using live search to buy cheap crafting bases, upgrades for build you play, to save time and currency on buying maps, and of course for flipping all kind of items and currency. You can use website like POE Trade, choose league in which you play, search for item you need, let's say you wish to buy 6 link lore with body armor, for minimum links write 6, then hit search. You can see what is minimum price, in case that is too expensive for you, or you wish to try to flip this item, click on show search form to go back to your search. Now under buyout, maximum price, write your desired price, select currency and hit search. You can see there is no items under that price. Now click here to perform the search in live mode, check notify with sound, check notify with browser notification, and as soon as someone posts item you wish to buy under your desired price, you will be notified with sound, item will be listed on that page, and you can try to contact seller as fast as possible, because many other players will probably do the same. Beside POE Trade, you can use trading page on official Path of Exile website, which I prefer to use because of one special mod filter that lets you set minimum empty affixes for prefix and suffix. In Betrayal League, with help of this mod filter, I was able to buy a huge number of cheap boots, gloves, helmets and all other kind of items. Then I will just use my crafting bench to mastercraft some good mod and increase value of items. In case where there was space for two mods, I would add one mod with my crafting bench and then place Leo rank 3 inside research safe house and use his crafting bench to add one more random mod for free, or I would just increase price and try to sell with one empty mod because I noticed people was willing to pay more, I guess with plan to use Leo by themselves. Now you may ask how to set up stat filters, at what price to buy items with empty mods, and how to find how much profit you can make. I will use boots as an example. In Betrayal League I was looking to buy upgrades for my boots, so I first set up stat filters similar to my boots and hit search without setting mod filter. There was lots of boots with cheap price because most of them didn't have empty mod. Now I start increasing total elemental resistance and at minimum 120, price for that kind of boots was minimum 100 chaos. I checked my crafting bench and I was able to craft suffix double resistance mod with maximum roll of 20, meaning I could add 40% to total elemental resistance, if there was empty suffix. Now in my search I added minimum empty suffix of 1, under miscellaneous I selected no for corrupted, crafted and mirrored and press search. There were several boots with prices between 5 and 30 chaos. I got all, crafted double res mod and placed in my shop with prices up to 100 chaos. Now I was curious to find out what is price for boots with minimum 80 total resistance and with minimum 120 life. And again price was around 100 chaos. As I was able to craft hybrid life prefix mod with up to 28 life, I did new search, this time I added minimum empty prefix at 1 and there was 4 boots with prices between 10 and 20 chaos. I got all that already didn't have this hybrid mod, crafted prefix and placed in shop again with prices up to 100 chaos. As I sold most of the boots in next 2 days, I realized this is good method for making currency and I set up live search. You just need to add trade filter with your desired maximum buyout price, hit search and then press activate live search to receive notification when next is posted. Beside this, I usually use live search to find cheaper upgrades and crafting bases. For upgrades, just use search as you normally would, but under trade filter set maximum price you are willing to pay and start live search. For crafting bases, I usually search for leather elder belts, so under item category choose belt, then implicit to maximum life. Item level minimum 75, elder item yes, and no for corrupted and mirrored. I set my maximum buyout price at 5 chaos, which is 5 to 10 chaos cheaper than usual price. Next crafting base I look to buy is elder ring. I set stat filters for bases like coral ring and 2 stone ring. And then I set minimum item level of 80, Select yes for Elder and no for Corrupted and Mirrored. If these rings are between 35 and 40 chaos, I set my buyout price between 20 and 25. Besides Elder belts and rings, I use Life Surge to buy many other Shaper and Elder based items I plan to use for crafting. I also use Life Surge when I need to buy maps, as it can save some time. Let's say you wish to buy Spider Forest map, you press search and now start messaging people. Sometimes you need to send message to 10 or more people before finding someone willing to sell. Reason: many players hate buying maps. In most cases, you can save time by buying maps in bulk, or if you need to buy just one, by using a live search. I usually have open up to 10 browser tabs with live searches. To have them ready for next gaming session, right click on one of the browser tabs, press select all tabs, now right click again and select bookmark tabs. Now choose the name of folder and where you wish to save it. Next time you wish to use these live searches, click on bookmarks, find that folder and choose option open all in tabs. Also, for every live search, you can click on settings and choose notification sound and notification volume. If you like spending time inside your hideout, you can use trade chat to make some currency. Depending how good you are in flipping items and currency, you can make some nice profit. Usually on trade chat, it's possible to buy items and currency much cheaper than on trading websites. You can even try to buy fossils and resonators at their single item price, then later sell them at higher price in bulk. Also, when you post items and currency you wish to buy or sell, it is not enough to post that just on trade chat 1. Usually you need to post at least on all trade chats between 1 and 20, so more players see your post. Also, many players use trade chat to buy 60 unique rings they need for vendor recipe to get Lore Weave unique body armor, with posting something like want to buy any unique rings, 1 chaos each. Next method that can bring huge profit is flipping items and currency. Use currency.poe.rate to find out current ratio for all currency and some items like divination cards, maps, scarabs, fossils and resonators. Use live search and trade chat to flip items and currency that will bring you highest profit. On PoE Ninja, choose league in which you play and find out what items are most expensive and how their price change over time. Always buy currency and items that have high chance of going up and not down with price over time. So in case you don't sell them fast, you will not lose currency. If you know what you're doing, crafting is one of the easiest ways to make huge amount of currency, though there are few big problems with investing currency in crafting. First, most of crafting results are random based and some crafting needs high investment. To find all about mods I need for my crafting, I use website PoEDB. I will explain this on Elder Belts. So first on mod page, choose belts. Here you can see all mods that belts can have. Now let's see Elder mods. Two most important mods I wish to craft on Elder Belt are increase life recovery rate and increase maximum life. Now I check minimum item level for highest tier of those mods. For increase maximum life it is 8 to 10% and on left side you can see that minimum item level is 75. For increase life recovery rate is 16 to 20% and again minimum item level is 75. Now I also check for other important Elder mods and also for normal mods like to maximum life, which is 68, increase elemental damage with attack skills, which is item level 86, and for resistance, which is item level 84. Because Elder belts with minimum item level 84 are expensive, I choose to buy Elder belts with minimum item level of 75. I usually use alteration orbs for my crafting. If you plan to use essences or fossils, on this site you can see a list of all mods you can get and which essence or fossil you need to use. Also, you can see a list of implicit mods you can get in case you use Val orbs. When I wish to invest more in crafting, I like to buy Shaper and Elder crafting bases with minimum item level 84 or 85. Here, some items I crafted and sold in Betrayal League. Elder Belt crafted with Alteration Orbs with increased life recovery rate and increased maximum life for 140 chaos. Shaper Amulet crafted with Screaming Essence of Hatred sold for 9 Exalted Orbs. Elder Ring crafted with Essence of Hysteria sold for 6 Exalted Orbs. Shaper Amulet crafted with Chaos Orbs sold for 1 Exalted Orb. Elder Ring crafted with Chaos Orbs sold for 5 Exalted Orbs. If you wish to try crafting with fossils, you can watch a really nice fossil crafting guide from Ziggy D, and also how to craft Stygian Vice belts with fossils by The Amigo Boys. This will be all for first part of this guide. I will try to make second part in first week of new expansion. Thanks for watching and see you next time!